Whether it was a burst dam or the rise of Islam, something made the Jews abandon Sena. When they did, the only way open to them would have been to head for the coast, and for some at least, that meant catching the monsoon winds south to Africa.
So he says it's about 20 days, and that's without the motor, so just with the sails. Is that right?
I knew from the DNA research that some of the men who left the Yemen for Africa were ancestors of the Bulba clan. These men had a Y chromosome pattern characteristic of the Kohanim, the ancient Jewish priestly class. They were among the forefathers of today's Lemba. I was interested to know whether genetic research could tell me anything about how many men had been in that founding group.
When we were looking at the male contribution to the gene pool of the Lemba, we came down to a small number, something like 8 or 9 men who could be thought of as having come to that group and left their Y chromosomes.
That is pretty remarkable, because there is a Lemba tradition.
Yes.
That their original number was about 14 or 15 in a boat, and the boat split into two.
Yes.
And 7 of them came south towards southern Africa.
Yes.
So it's completely kind of consistent.
Yes.
With your,
yes,
with your findings.
Yes.
2,500 years ago, the Ark of the Covenant, perhaps the holiest object on the face of the earth, vanished without trace. Lemba oral traditions say that a small group of men, some of them members of the priestly Bulba clan, left Jerusalem at the time of the Babylonian invasion, settled in Sena, and later came to Africa, carrying with them a sacred object called Ngomalungundu.
So what exactly is this Ngomalungundu?
It means a drum that thunders. It was perceived as the voice of their god. It was carried by the Lemba people. It was not supposed to touch the ground. It was not supposed to be touched improperly by other people. And it played a tremendous role in their history. It was actually used during war, and it had an effect on the enemy. It rendered them powerless.
At some time in the past, the Ngoma was lost to the Lemba. But then, 60 years ago, it was found, damaged by fire, in a cave alongside the Limpopo, on the border between Zimbabwe and South Africa, by a German missionary called Harold von Sickard. And it seemed I was not alone in believing there was a strong connection between the Ngoma and the Ark.
Early missionaries like von Sickard examined the parallels between the Ngomalungundu and the Ark of the Covenant. In his book, it's called An Afrikanische Bundeslade. It means it's an African Ark of the Covenant.
Absolutely fascinating.
You can see the different holes there and the handle.
And that looks like the remains of a handle here.
Exactly. It was where the pole went through when they carried the Ngomalungundu. And even in Lemba tradition, I think it's so obvious to them that they don't really say, but this is the Ark of the Covenant, but it's so similar. It functioned as such.
Was the Ngoma one of the things that you heard about when you were a kid?
We have been told that the Ngoma it was having power. It was used like a weapon, especially when they move throughout. And then it is very important to us, and as something which makes to differentiate the Lemba with some other cultures, that it was ruled by the Lemba only.
What the Ark was doing, this Ngoma was doing.
Yeah.
You see, protecting the people, making them victorious wherever they went. The armies were always invincible. Then I don't have any doubt they have a connection.
So do you think that they were the same thing?
I don't think so.
I have traced Jewish traditions and genetic links from ancient Jerusalem through Arabia and the Yemen to the Lemba tribe of southern Africa. Was there any evidence that the ancestors of the Lemba had brought their sacred drum, the Ngomalungundu, with them from the Yemen? Magda LaRue's search amongst the writings of early Muslim historians furnished a clue.
In 1150, an early Arab historian, Idrisi, refers to the possessors of the Ngomalungundu, and he said they were closely associated with the people who carried the drum, the Lemba. And that was 1150 at the east coast of Africa.
The East African coast was exactly the place I would have expected the Lemba to have been 9 centuries ago if they'd recently left the Yemen. And perhaps Idrisi saw them carrying their most sacred object with them. I was convinced that the object they brought was the Ark of the Covenant.